Alright, welcome back to the Swedish King of the North achievement run. This is part 19, and I don't want you guys to think that I've went too far ahead. In fact, I've only went about a few months ahead of the previous episode, and this has just came up. The heir has fallen ill, and this is not really a problem, considering the heir to our throne is mediocre at best. So we are going to pray for his life, and see where that takes us. I think he survived, actually. Quite surprisingly, he's alive, and we've gained legitimacy, so that's cool. In the last episode, we have won the Holy Romen Empire War for the Protestant League. We've gained a new achievement, and basically the official religion of the Holy Roman Empire is now Protestant, which is fantastic. On to the bad news. The bad news is that our vassal, which is Mons and Cologne, are no longer electors, which is a bit silly, but that is exactly what it is. We are training a new army, and we are still focusing on annexing Muscovy. So, without further ado, let's go ahead and take off where we left off. In this episode, we're going to declare war on Verdun and take some more territory, I guess you could say, in the Holy Roman Empire, which is a good thing. Let's see if the Hansa is still... They're not. So we can actually declare war on the Hansa as well. And we might. I'm not really quite sure what we should do at this point, if we should go for it or not. Of course, our navy is massive. And... Right, so let's go ahead and continue where we left off. Again, we are making a new army, which is fantastic news. Converting more provinces, nothing new there. Let's ensure that we are not converting any of these provinces here, Hertesh and Tumen. We will convert them later after we core them. So we will convert Kazan instead. Of course, converting Sunni provinces takes quite a bit longer, most unfortunately, but that is just the way it works. So again, we are going to declare war on Verdun. And I'm not really quite sure how we're going to get our men over there. We might have to ferry them over there. And we've actually got quite a bit of a coalition against us as well. We're going to take a look at that right now. So Brandenburg is in a coalition against us, as is Pomerania and the Hansa. But besides that, really nobody else is, which is pretty damn good. Right, so let's go ahead and take a look at our mission. Conquer Ukermik. Where is that exactly? Ukermik is here. Ukermark, I should say. We will conquer that. That's fine. And take all of these provinces in the next coalition war. So that's great. Of course, I believe Ludenberg is also... Oh, they're not in a coalition with us, but they practically should be at this point. Again, we are training yet another army using the new... what's it called? The new army organization type of screen, which is nice. We've also claimed on Frankfurt, that's fine, not a big deal. And we have a new colony that is self-sustaining, which is fantastic. Pretty soon over here in Alaska, or rather Canada, we will have enough men, or rather enough territories, to make our, colonial government. Let's go and take a look at the economic map mode. So the Gulf of St. Lawrence is where we want to colonize. Of course, we are going to try to take all of these coastal provinces, as they will be the first provinces that are snatched up by those pesky Europeans. I'm going to opt now and opt to take Signet as the next colony. We're going to send a unit over there right around now. And... as soon as our agent is done fabricating a claim, we are going to go ahead and declare war. Of course, Brandenburg has just opted out of the military coalition, so that's good for us. Pomerania is still in the coalition, as is... Well, that seems about it. So, let's declare war in Pomerania next turn. They're allied with Anhalt, Brabant, Brunswick, and Bohemia. Let's see if any of these guys are... They're not. Burgundy is. I didn't even know that Burgundy was still around, which is a bit surprising. Brabant and Ansbach are also in a coalition. Brabant, Ansbach, I do not see them anywhere, so that's fine, not a big deal. Again, The Hansa are not in a coalition with us, but I really do want to attack them. They are, of course, allied with Austria and the Netherlands. Really, our main chokehold is going to be admin power. We need to focus admin power. Our current king is really shitty with admin power, so we might actually opt to kill him. Alright, so without further ado, let's go ahead and declare war on Verdun. They're in a coalition against us, that's fine. They're also allied with Bavaria and Saxony. Bavaria, Saxony's an elector. And we should probably go ahead and vassalize Saxony, if we can. And I believe we probably can. So, that being said, let's go ahead and declare war on Verdun, just like so. And they will call upon the coalition members, blah, 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 blah. We don't really care, not going to be a problem. We can even call in Lithuania, which is fantastic news. So, let's go ahead and do that. We're going to take Stead as a vassal. And just like that, we are at war. Right, so immediately, I'm going to go ahead and move some of my men from the east over to the western theater. Of course, these provinces do have unrest, but we can go ahead and increase their autonomy. They're not really going to give us any money anyways for quite a while, so we will increase their autonomy just like so. And they're good to go. Of course, Sirgut will be completed as a colony pretty soon too. We can move on to the east, taking some of these provinces up here, which are a bit more rich. In fact, this is River Estuary, the Taz Estuary, so we will take that next. And let's go ahead and send this unit to the west to meet up with the rest of our units. So again, we've got Lithuania at our side. In fact, we have our vassals as well, which is fantastic news. Getting to Stad will be quite easy. We can just move directly across the Hansa, actually, without even asking them for military access. We don't really care. And our colony is self-sustaining in Valsi as well, which is great. We've lost an advisor. That's fine. We'll go ahead and take... Well, we can't afford a really good one, so we'll take the next best thing. I'm tempted to get a missionary strength advisor, just because money is really not an object to us right now, and we could use the added admin points that this will give us. Of course, we are sending more of our colonists out into Canada. Let's go back into Europe now, where we are at war with the Holy Roman Empire. So, immediately, let's go ahead and... Ravensburg... I thought the Hansa would be in a coalition against us. They are not. We will most definitely make our ruler a general, as this will increase the chance that he dies, which is important, whilst also fabricating claims on the Hansa, as we plan on taking out the Hansa eventually. But none of these provinces are worth taking. Let's go now to fabricate claims on Brandenburg, like Berlin. Berlin will be a very nice province to take, of course, the modern-day capital of the German state. And we're going to go now over here. We've lost the Siege of Yaroslavl. Oh, Muscovy is in a coalition against us. Or rather, Novgorod is in a coalition against us. I didn't even know that they were still around. It's pretty funny. But it seems like Muscovy is taking them out, so we don't really care. And as to the rest of these men, we will keep a unit in Saxe-Lauenburg, just in case. We're all sending men over here. Let's take a look at our military force limit. It's pretty good, actually. We can work on making another army here in a minute, and we will, so that's fine. Let's take a look at how expensive this would be. This template would cost 299 to build. We are almost there. I think we'll be able to get there in the next month or so, so that's good. We'll just gain local autonomy and this feed over it. We don't really care. I do apologize, I'm a bit quieter right now. It is later at night, so I can't really speak too loudly, guys. Pomerania actually did not choose to join us, or join against us in this war, which is unfortunate because I really wanted to take their last province. So we're going to have to put that on hold. Instead, we can go ahead and opt to attack Saxony, which is probably what we're going to do right now after making another Gustavus special over here in Swedish Pomerania, or rather Swedish, I guess, Prussia. So we're going to go ahead and move in on Saxony, just like so, And we need to go ahead and slow down the speed just a bit because it's a bit too fast for us. Perfect, just like that. And the Battle of Stad is over. We've taken the war goal. We can move now on to Brunswick. Let's see, Brunswick. Is Brunswick an elector? They are not. Burgundy is. I just have no idea where Burgundy is, to be honest. Let's take a look at our diplomatic map mode. Burgundy. They're over here. So we could probably vassalize them as well. Again, we only really need three electors to choose us. So we will force vassalize Saxony, Verdun, and Burgundy in this war. It's going to give us an absolutely insane amount of aggressive expansion, but that's okay. We don't really care. I'm really worried about the monthly diplomatic power gain that we're going to get, which is going to be pretty damn high, honestly. But it is what it is. It's not a big deal. So Saxony is actually under attack by Bohemia right now, just as we speak. It's pretty good, I guess, for us. Theologian has died. That's fine. Again, our navy has absolute superiority, I guess you could say, which is good. And our army is joining forces over here in Königsberg. We've taken Wittenberg. On to Leipzig. Okay, none of these guys are at war with us. That's good. Good news. And I think we'll probably forfeit this territory once we move. Oh, no, we won't. That's good. Let's see now if we can work on coring any more of these provinces. We can't just yet, but we can soon. Truce with Spanish Brazil and Spain has expired. In fact, we are now making much less money in war operations, so that's fine, not a big deal. And we'll be ready for any attack on our men. Of course, our vassals are taking most of the heat for us, which is good. And look at Ravensburg. Ravensburg is trying to take back Stad, it seems, or maybe even making a move on our territory. Truce with Aachen has expired, no worries there. Let's go ahead and make a claim on Urtesh. And send another missionary to Tiumen, that's fine. No big deal there. So we've taken Leipzig, which is good news. We're going to move on now to the province that has a castle, which is Sachsen. We should be able to take it pretty fast, in fact, because Bohemia just made peace with Saxony. And pretty soon we're going to have another army, which is fantastic news for us. Of course, our manpower is incredibly low, but that's not the end of the world. So that's good news. And it looks like we need to reinforce our allied army up there, but we're not going to, so it's not a big deal. We will instead opt to take them out here in a minute. Truce with France is over, that's fine, not a big deal. As soon as we take Braunschweig, we will launch an attack to retake Stad. That is, in fact, my goal at this point in time. Our army is very slowly regrouping over there in Swedish Prussia, as the cannons take quite a while to actually hire. So nothing really new to report here. Still sieging these provinces. Might take a little while. And the only unfortunate thing is that I don't think we can make a separate peace with many of these guys. Okay, we can make a separate peace with Saxony, that's good. And a Novgorod as well. We can use Muscovy's claim of it as a province that will help us out even more, which is fantastic news. That way we can go ahead and take it back when we annex Muscovy as well. So, over here in Saxony, we're doing a pretty good job. We might even lose Stad, but that's okay, not the end of the world, so we don't really care. Of course, our vassal Mons has been completely annexed, but that's not a big deal. Again, we don't really care. And here we go. We've got more of an army up here, which is good. We're going to go ahead and immediately attack them. Just like so. Good. Just like that. And we need to reinforce our army down here in the south. Hopefully we get there in time. I think we probably will. Let's see if we do. The 10th of March. The 15th of March. Hopefully that's enough time. I believe it was. Fantastic. And our other army is almost done. I believe in 36 days it'll be completed. Let's go now to Novgorod, which has... Oh, we can't make a separate piece of Novgorod, so we will opt not to do that. Instead, we can make a separate piece with Bavaria and Burgundy once they are fully annexed. In fact, we could just destroy the Holy Roman Empire, but I've already attained this particular achievement, so it's not something that I really am looking to accomplish in this playthrough. Again, we are just going to annex the rest of this territory. Shouldn't take much longer now, with Saxony almost out of the war and down for the count. Battle of Sachsen has over. Fantastic. Saxony, of course, is already almost at 100% war exhaustion here, or rather war score. And we have another army which is sent into the Holy Roman Empire. We have 80,000 men, which is really quite a bit that we can throw in over here. And let's see if any of these other countries are at war with us. Palatinate is, of course, so we will go ahead and opt to take them out. Austria is not, actually, surprisingly. So, who else is at war with us? Not the Netherlands. What about... Okay, so we're going to go ahead and free up our vassal over here in Mons. Just a tad. Sweden has occupied Berlin. What about our colonies over here? Are we okay? Yes, so far so good. No problems over here. And let's go back over to the east, into the old world, where we are done with Saxony. Let's go ahead and see if we can make a peace with them. Be certainly nice if we could. We cannot actually make them a vassal, unfortunately, which is really, really shitty. They've taken more land, I think that's why. They could return some cores, however, to Brunswick and Lunesburg. If they were to do that, could I perhaps make them a vassal? No, I can't. So we can't, let's forget about making them a vassal, we can't do it. Instead, they will pay us war reparations and give us some money. Well, that's not really a lot, is it? Those are some treaties as well, just like so. Really need to give us some prestige, right? So, and besides that, they can't really give us anything else, so that's fine for the moment. And who else? Bavaria and Burgundy. So Bavaria is going to be down here somewhere. Bavaria is actually already occupied by Bohemia, but we'll take them out later on. Let's instead take Ansbach, who is also at war with us. And moving our men, of course, to capitalize on the weakness of the enemy alliance. Let's go ahead and claim some more territory from Brandenburg. Okay, we can't. What about more territory from Lüneburg? Maybe Lüneburg proper. Or Ostfriesland. That's a bit too far away from us, actually. Well, we could do it, I guess. But I would rather claim Siberia land over here in the east, just because we are going to take it out eventually. Might as well make it cheaper for us. And how are our missionaries doing in Taman? They're doing pretty well. We'll be able to core that pretty soon as well. So far so good. And the Central Holy Roman Empire, where we are freeing our vassal Mons and about to push back into enemy territory here. Of course, who is currently at war with us? These red guys you see right here. Brabant being the biggest of them. So we're going to go ahead and immediately send out a unit into Brabant. Loss of claim on Chesapeake, that's fine, not a big deal. And quite annoyingly, we've got a unit heading over to Hoya. That is why I'm keeping a unit up here, just in case. We'll be able to take over this particular area. Of course, we could make our heir a general. He's really, really good. They might cross over a river here, though. They will. But I have no doubt in my mind that we will win this battle. At least we try to. We're getting really shitty rolls, actually. So, tell you what. We're actually going to send out some more units that way. We probably won't get there in time, but it was worth a shot. Of course, we're not going to win every battle that we set out upon, but we win the majority of them, so that's the important thing. Let's go ahead and set up a leader here. Okay, we can't. Well, here we go. Let's see if this works. Hopefully it does. Let's ensure that our maintenance is at the highest it is. It is. Let's see if this works. These are running pretty far away. Okay, we were able to win the day. That's great. Keeping an eye on this unit over here. Who is running back to Danzig? We will take him back into the fray soon enough. Of course, our manpower is really, really shitty at this point in time, but that's okay. Nothing in the world. We are taking out the Palatinate as well, which is good. And I would take out Bavaria if we were able to do so, but we're not. Instead, Ravensburg, we will opt to take out instead. Hesh is at peace with us, so we can't do anything over there. So straight to Ravensburg we go. Probably shouldn't have done that just yet. I thought I had a full stack of units, but I did not. But that's okay, not a big deal. We are going to send our men over here to the north, where we have better supply lines to Sweden proper. And we've won the Battle of Ravensburg, which is great. Now we're just taking back our vassals' territory, which is going to be useful for us. And pretty soon, our other colony in Siberia will be completed, which is fantastic news. In fact, I think what I'm going to do now is abandon this colony over here by recalling and sending... Well, first of all, these units over here can regroup with our units there. Oh, well, nominally they could, but they are blocked by a few, I guess, native countries. So we're going to send a colonist up here to Mangosa, or Mangazia. Colonists will ride there in a little bit longer than a year. We gain a new core province, which is fantastic. And really, we're doing pretty well. I need to ensure that we are able to take out Burgundy, as we can vassalize them as well. So now, let's go ahead and send out our men to attack into Brabant to occupy them. That way we can open up the road to attacking Burgundy, which is important. So again, we've got an army over here in Mons ready to reinforce our units. And if you think you're going to attack us there, you're stupid. We're going to strike back over that way. We cannot let Brabant succeed over here. Luxembourg against France, Scotland, Brunswick, Lorraine, and Spain. What about Luxembourg? What? Who is on your side? Nobody just yet. I'm a little bit apprehensive to joining a fight. Let's go ahead and opt to gain admin power. That's fine. And we've won the Battle of Ansbach 2, which is fantastic news. Time to move on to the Northern Front. France is at war with Luxembourg and Aachen, and Luxembourg is at war with just France. So we could hop into the war against France, but I don't really want to be honest with you. So we're going to opt out of it. Of course, now we lose Defender of the Faith, but that's not a big deal. Nobody really cares. Let's go ahead and take out Ravensburg's final army and make a move on Brabant. Fantastic. So the war is now going in our favor, which is good news. In fact, let's go ahead and take out Burgundy as well. Get them out for the count. We've won the Battle of Ravensburg, which is also fantastic. Is Bavaria free from Bohemia yet? Not quite. So we will send our men up to the north. We gain more casus bellies here against Sevier. And just to plan, Sirgut has been colonized. We're going to now send our troops up to Mangosa, just like so. Surprising that there are any, actually, natives in this area, but there are, which is interesting. and we are about to have a free diplomat as well, which is good. So the Battle of Cambrai, we've won, unsurprisingly. Pretty soon we will make peace. And we can invest in new technology, we shall. This gives us access to new infantry. And we'll go into upgrade soon, because I have a little bit of a hint where you want to upgrade at the end of the month, because upgrading actually decreases your unit's morale. We're going to take Mauritian infantry, which are much better. And now we've upgraded, which is fantastic news. So Lithuania is helping us out a bit over here in Brabant, which is good news, as Bohemia has been taken out previously, so they are not an issue. We're going to keep him there. And we really need to work on our manpower as well after this war is over. We've lost a claim on a province, probably in Poland. Yeah, it's not a big deal. We don't really care too much about Poland. Now that that conversion is successful, we can core the last province of Sibir. And go ahead and work on converting more of our provinces, which is also really good. Go ahead and send our men to Provence. Just like so. Reformers, praise the Church of Sweden. Let's go ahead and just gain church power. That's fine, not a big deal. In fact, we should also just keep this guy in mods, as Brabant has a relatively big force in Hanut. So we're going to ignore that for the time being. Keep my eye on Bohemia, just because Bohemia, or rather Bavaria, is at war with us, but they are currently 100% occupied by Bohemia. We can take Defender of the Faith. In fact, this would give us missionaries, monthly war exhaustion, yearly prestige. Let's go ahead and do that. That's fine. We're in a pretty good position overall. We've won the Battle of Cambrai, unsurprisingly. And we're going to go ahead and switch off to our general, or rather our leader, and take out the final opposition army against us. I believe this will be the last one. In fact, we can go ahead and vassalize Burgundy, as they are an elector. Let's go ahead and do so right now. Burgundy... Oh shit, but Burgundy is also at war with somebody else. They're also at war with Bohemia, Lorraine, Pomerania, Venice, and Aachen. Is it worth it? Absolutely, it is worth it. So, Lorraine, Pomerania, Venice, and Aachen. I better prepare myself for a battle with Bohemia. Ooh, jeez. Well, it is what it is. Let's go ahead and wait before we make peace with him. Instead, we can make peace with Bavaria right now. We can just white peace them, that's fine. Oh, but we can also make them a vassal too. It's tempting. So I know Bavaria is... Oh shit, Bavaria is actually the emperor. Huh. Let's make peace with the emperor for now. That's fine. We don't want to fight him later. We'll make peace with him. And... pretty soon we will vassalize Burgundy, which will bring us into war against Bohemia. Let's go ahead and do that now, because why not, honestly? But we need to prepare ourselves, actually. Let's go ahead and take out Brabant first. Okay, we are exiled, which means that we need to get back to our territory, which is just annoying, but it is what it is. We'll send you that way. Let's send you to Brabant. Blocked by a hostile fort, huh? What about you? Can you get over there? You can't. Well, that's weird. Wish we could. And you? Are you also blocked by... Okay, so this must be the hostile fort that we're talking about, Lindbergh. Again, we don't care too much. It's not a big deal. We're going to send these guys back. Just like so. And we have a lot of men that we need to regain eventually. Truce with Mons is over. That's fine. Need a new province, which is good. And our overextension is almost dead. Check it out, we actually have a new colony over here in Gaza. Our name is spreading across Siberia like a wildfire, which is nice. Again, we're doing a pretty good job. And pretty soon we can take out Brabant itself, which is the goal. as soon as we take out this territory over here. I want to speed that up just a little bit, if we can do so, as they are seeking to take back Rabat for themselves. Let's see if this works. Need to speed this up just a little bit. Just a tad, so we can make peace and prepare for war with Bohemia. Austria has declared war on Venice, that's fine. We don't really mind too much. I'm gonna go ahead and free up Mons as well. Truce with Wittenberg is over, that's fine, not a big deal. And pretty soon we're going to have 100% war score. In fact, we could probably already make peace pretty reliably. Move you guys back that way as well. How many people is Burgundy at war with now? Just Bohemia, Lorraine, Pomerania, Venice, and Aachen. That's fine. Not the end of the world. Let's go ahead and... well, once our men are... passed through Bohemia, we will declare war. We've won against Brabant, that's fantastic. Again, we are just going to move our men back that way, if we can. Just to get back out of the conflict once we inevitably vassalize Burgundy for ourselves. In fact, let's go ahead and preemptively release Cologne as a vassal. Just because we are going to have, we're going to be over the diplomatic relations limit by quite a bit. So that's fine. Go ahead and release them as a vassal. Now they hate us, but that's okay. I thought they would actually appreciate us breaking their vassalization, but they won't. Move you back over here, and let's go ahead and make peace with Burgundy. Which of course will drag us into war, but that's fine, we're ready for that. So we will vassalize Burgundy and take some money and force them to give up claims in France, which will give us a little bit of prestige, which is good. In fact, I don't want them to give up claims in Brabant, because then we can use this vassal to take back the claims of Brabant. Thus, yeah, we're going to keep them like that, so that's fine. Burgundy will become a vassal of us, that's good. In fact, we are actually not at war with Bohemia anymore. They must have changed the mechanics on how this works to prevent abuse, so that's fine. Again, we have taken Burgundy as a vassal, which is fantastic news. All we need now is to take Verdun as a vassal as well, and we will be in good standing. I'm going to go ahead and do that very soon. We've won the Battle of Mons, which is good. Now I'm just moving my men back into Swedish territory. Let's go and make peace. So, peace. We are going to take Verdun as a vassal, just like so. And we are also going to take some territory, I do believe. Like... returning cores to... okay, so we can't return Novgorod to Muscovy. I wish we could. Let's see, where is Novgorod? Really, Novgorod's not here. We can't take Kaluga. Okay, Kaluga. Right there. We're going to take that. It's fine. Anything else? We could take more vassals. But I don't think any of these guys are actually electors. Let's see... Saxony, Verdun, Hunnuts, Brandenburg, Burgundy. Yeah, the rest of these guys, I don't really want them as vassals. So this peace deal looks pretty good to me. I wish we could take more, but it is what it is. Yeah, that's fine. Again, not the end of the world. I could take Stad as a territory, but I want it to be an elector, so let's go ahead and do this. Again, this war could have gone a little bit better if I, you know, had done things differently, but it's okay. We didn't do too bad. Let's go ahead and end it. So, Verdun is now a vassal of me, which is fantastic. Now we are above our diplomatic relations, which is not good, but it's okay. Not at the end of the world. Again, we got three vassals, Mons, Verdun, Burgundy. So now we should just take out Saxony, Hesse, and Hanut. Where is Hanut? Hanut's over here somewhere. Come on, Hanut, where are you at? Hanut is over... Where the hell is Hanut? I knew they were over here somewhere. Come on. Where are you guys? Okay, fine. We'll just take Saxony. And Brandenburg will also be a target for us to take out. That's fine. Where the hell is Hanut? Let's see if there's actually a province named Hanut. There is. It's over here. Okay, so it's pretty far away, actually. And I don't think we have a valid casus belli on them, so it is what it is. Let's see if we can use... No, that's Liege. So I'm going to check the time real quick. I need to end this episode pretty soon. That's fine. I'm going to move, again, our men back into Sweden. Well, I can't move these men, these guys back into Sweden. These guys will be stuck in the center of the Holy Roman Empire for now, but it's not a big deal. Not the end of the world. Let's go ahead and work on increasing our relationships with Verdun just for the time being. We can in December. And a lot of new faces have decided to enter a military coalition against us. That's fine. As soon as our manpower is up quite a bit, we can declare war. We're just going to wait a tad for our manpower to work its way up. Of course, now with two vassals, this will make things a lot easier, which is good news. We only need about one more vassal, maybe two max, to become emperor. So we're almost there. We are almost emperor, which is really good news. Do we have any other cores? We do. Kaluga over here, outside of Lithuania, which is good. I think we're going to get some more border, I guess, friction with Lithuania now. But nothing we can handle, only negative five. Not too bad. They seem to like us quite a bit. So I'm not too worried about that. We will gain just a little bit of, or lose just a little bit of prestige, that's fine. Converting more territory. Again, I really need to work on my admin tech. We are quite a bit behind in admin tech for the time being. But we're ahead in military tech, which means that we can go ahead and increase the development of Stockholm just a little bit. I would like to increase development to 60 so I can get that achievement. It's just going to take a little while to get there, honestly. That's fine. Let's go ahead and continue where we left off. Again, this episode's only going to be about 2 more minutes long while I finish working on what I'll be doing in the next episode. We are, of course, probably going to declare war on the Hansa as well. They're allied with Saxony. But that's not the Elector I want to declare war on. I want to declare war on Bavaria, who is allied with Hesse, Meringen, and Nuremberg. Nuremberg is... Let's see where Nuremberg is. Down here? Huh. Well, I really need to declare war on Bavaria, who I think is actually the Emperor, so that's fine. So that means I can declare war on anybody, really, and vassalize them accordingly. But I'm worried that if Bavaria, if there's a different emperor, maybe they can change the electors up, so I'm a bit apprehensive to do that. Instead, I would like to take out Brandenburg, who... Huh. We need Hesse as well. They're allied with Bavaria, Brunswick, Cleves, and Wittenberg. Cleves is going to be up here somewhere, I believe. Man, the Holy Roman Empire is freaking confusing. Let's just take out Brandenburg, actually. Next episode, we'll take a little bit of Brandenburg in territory and work our way into the Holy Roman Empire that way. So that's fine. Not a big deal. In fact, we could declare war on Pomerania as well. Might be a good idea. We will choose to take National Tax Modifier. That's fine. Just like so. And pretty soon, our cores will be done in Tumen and Kaluga, which is fantastic news. Let's go ahead and change our national focus what we can in 1598, so we're going to have to wait a little while, but that's alright, we can wait. Let's see how our colonial nation is doing over on the east coast of North America. We do see Portuguese Louisiana and English Mexico off the coast to the southwest, but that's okay. Oscar Land is doing pretty well, although they have yet to really convert any provinces to our culture. Of course, these are the original provinces that we have colonized in the first place. So no worries there. Let's see, once we are positive with Verdun, if they would elect to choose us in the next coming cycle. Let's take a look. Verdun is right here. They would not really choose us over Brandenburg. That's annoying. What if we married them? Maybe that would increase the relationship with them just a little bit. Let's go and see. Would you marry us? You won't, because your form of government does not allow royal marriages. Well, that's annoying. What about you, Burgundy? Would you royal marry us? You would? Fantastic. Burgundy would also not. So we need to work on increasing our relationship with our, I guess, electors. And Cleese has entered a coalition with us as well. Fantastic. And Nuremberg as well is a new elector. So the electors have been filled, really. So again, guys, stay tuned for the next episode. We are going to increase our relationship with everybody and take out Brandenburg, or at least try to. But we will be able to. It's just a matter of if we can vassalize them in one go. I think we have to weaken them in a war or two. I think one war should be enough to weaken them enough. But again, our overextension is almost completed. So again, guys, I want to thank you guys very much for watching. Stay tuned for the next episode where we go to war with Brandenburg and really face quite a coalition. In fact, if you take a look here, let's see how big this coalition against us is. It's pretty massive, actually. But I'm not really afraid of it. This includes Alsace, Wittenberg, Aachen, Cleves, and others. Of course, none of these are electors. But it is what it is. We will make war with them anyways. So again, guys, stay tuned, and I will see you on the next episode.